Have you ever looked up at the night sky and started wondering about bizarre stuff that happens up there? I mean, almost everything that happens in space is strange to us, because we don't have that sort of personal experience with those stuff. Stars, black holes, galaxies, supernovas, etc. But on this bizarreness scale, a few things come even close to neutron stars. I mean, do you remember the first time you picked up a piece of lead? I do, and I remember how blown away I was by the fact that something so small can be so heavy. But that experience doesn't even begin to describe how heavy the neutron star is. For example, if you were to make a ball from neutronium 100 meters in diameter, it would be heavier than our entire planet. Neutron stars are really small. Compared to our sun, they are really, really small. Actually, compared to our planet, they are tiny. They are just a few kilometers across and they are spinning furiously fast. The fastest spinning neutron star that we discovered spins at a staggering rate of 700 revolutions per second. That's 60 million times faster than the Earth. Day and night cycle wouldn't exist if the Earth spun that fast. When we look up at the light bulb, we think that it's constantly shining, but if you look at the high-speed footage, we can see that it's actually turning on and off really fast, about 50 times per second. So if the Earth were to spin 700 times per second, it would be day, all day long. Our brains and our perceptions are really, really slow compared to this. But I wonder one more thing. If the Earth were to spin that fast, is that the only weird thing that would happen? You see, right now the gravity pulls us down, but at the same time, because we are spinning, the Earth pushes us outwards. Of course, the gravity is stronger and we stay where we are. However, the faster the Earth spins, the stronger this outward push will be, and then we'll come to a point where we'll become weightless. Completely weightless, just like the astronauts aboard International Space Station. And the amazing thing is that the Earth doesn't have to spin 700 times per second for this to happen. No, it only has to spin about 20 times faster than it's doing now. Or in other words, for this to happen, the day on Earth should have to be about 90 minutes long. Is this number familiar to you in any way? The astronauts aboard International Space Station go around the Earth in 90 minutes. This means that we will have to travel with the Earth at more than 28,000 kilometers per hour. But this is only the case if you were to live at or close to the equator. The further away from the equator you are, the slower you'll go and the heavier you'll become. Next time you look up at the night sky, try to imagine a world like this. Try to imagine a world where you would be floating freely around while your friends all over the world would be firmly connected to the ground. It's weird, isn't it? Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.